So we have discussed the constraints on the attributes, the constraint on the relationship basically in our previous session, where I have told you that there are two type of constraints on the relationships. First one is the we have discussed what is the cardinality ratio. We have also discussed what is the participation constants. For an information, we have discussed with an example like n is to m. This constrains the participating entities in the relation, in between the relationships among different entity types. We have also discussed what is the participation constraints, where I have introduced a total participation constraints with an example of department and the projects, where I have told that there is not any project which is not associated with some department. If all the projects are associated with any department, with some department, then it is a total participation, and you have introduced the total participation. With the help of double lines, project. Fine. Now, in this lecture, we are going to move on the same topic where we have discussed the attributes of the associations or the relationship types. Let us understand with the example, which will be more comfortable to understand. Like this. This is a department entity type. And this one is a project entity type. We have a relationship like this. Department handles the project. Let me be more specific here. Like this is M is to N. It means one department can handle N projects, and there is one project can be handled with the M departments. Let me specify some more things here, like budget. Now see carefully that what I have told that one department can have and projects and see from here that one project can be handled by M departments. It means there is a single project, it is associated or handled at different time phases by the different departments. Hence, we can also assume that for the handling of this project or for the completion of this project, there is a budget which is associated with this project. But right now, we are discussing a project X which is associated with some department X. Hence, this is not the total budget. This is not the total budget which is assigned for this project for the completion of this project. This is a part of that budget that is associated with this particular project, and at this time this budget is given to this department for handling this project at this time. This is known as the attribute of this relationship handles. This is associated at this time with this relationship in between the this particular department and for that particular project. Well, it is very clear because one project is handled by M departments. Hence, there is a big amount of project which is distributed among the different departments. And this is the part of that budget at this time when this project is handled at this particular or one particular department. This is the attribute of this particular relationship. Now, see more thing, like if this is the case, one project can be associated with a single department only, not the M departments, but one department can have N projects. Again, see, one project is associated with a single department. The whole work on this project need to done by a single department. In this case, what we can some more things on this relationship? Can we move this budget from here to this entity type or not? This is a very important question which arises here. We can conclude this thing with the conclusion that if the relationship is like 1:10 or this is 1:1, then we can move this budget or this attribute to the corresponding or relevant entity type, like here. Budget. How this is possible? This is the budget for this project, and this relationship very clearly says that this project is associated with only one department. Hence, the whole sum allocated to this particular project is consumed by this particular department. Hence, this is very much feasible to move this entity type and this attribute of this relationship to the corresponding entity type. This is a correct presentation, and you can also note that if the relationship is 1:N or 1:1, you can do this type of activities. Fine. Next, what is the identifying relationship? If we are going to discuss the identifying relationship, then we must know what is the weak entities. We also need to know the total participation, which we have discussed in our previous lecture. So let us understand this thing with a very simple example, where there is an entity type employer. It has different attributes. You can show with the ellipses. One attribute is a key attribute among given attributes, which is a PAN card number. Since this is the key attribute, we can represent with the help of underlines. Fine. There is another entity that is known as insurance details. It contains the details of insurance given to the employees. How this is related? This is the insurance record entity, which contains the records of different employees. This is a relationship that relates employee to the insurance record. Let us understand what we need to understand here. What is the identifying relationship? First thing, I am focusing on this entity type. This contains the insurance record. But if a case where our entity type does not have any key attribute to identify the different entities uniquely, these type of entity types are known as weak entity types. Like this one, insurance record have the records of the about the insurances of different employees, but it has no any primary key. We have not assigned or not given any primary key or any key that helps to identify these records or these entities uniquely. We used to say this type of entities as a weak entity, and how we will represent with the help of double line rectangles like this. First thing to know that in the weak entities there is no any key attribute. Second thing what need to note is that existence of such entities depends on the existence of some another entities. Without having these any other entity, we cannot identify or we cannot use or we cannot show these type of entities, which are, for example, insurance record. Until unless it is related with some employee, there is no importance or no existence of the such type of records. If there is a insurance record X, but for what? For whom this record is given? Until unless this record X is not related with the some employee X, this is irrelevant. No meaning of given this type of records or relations. Fine. So there are two points. First thing, in the weak entities, no key attribute is there. Second point, the existence of such entities depends on some different entities, and such type of entities are known as identifying entities. This is the identifying entities. Fine. This is the identifying entities. We used to hear by using which key attribute we are identifying this particular entity. The same attribute we can use to identify the corresponding insurance record. Hence, such type of relationships are known as identifying relationship. Listen again. In this relationship, the key attribute which is used to identify the employees uniquely is also used to identify the corresponding insurance record for that particular employee. Such type of relationships are known as identifying relationships. And how we will represent this identifying relationship? This is used to represent with the help of double line diamond shaped structures like this. This is known as identifying relation, identifying relationship. This is the weak entity. One more thing, what I have told you that every insurance record must be associated with some employer. If I am saying it must be associated, why? Because I have already told you that without any association to different entity, it has no existence, no meaning of such records. Hence, each and every record given in this entity type must associate with some different or identifying entity type. Like here, every insurance record must be associated with the employee entity type. If I am saying it must be, then you have to show a total participation here, like this. This is a total participation. You can write here. And this is identifying relationship. One question I am leaving for you. You have to think, the total participation is only with the weak entities or not? Is it correct statement if someone is saying that total participation is associated only with the weak entities? For the hint, I want to say that this is a false statement. The total participation is also associated with the strong entities. For an example, you can refer our previous lecture where we have discussed that departments are associated with the projects, where I have told that there is not a single project in the company that is not associated with any department. It means existence of that particular project, even projects have their project ID, project name, unique key attribute is the project ID. Project is not a weak entity, it has the unique keys or keys, but still we have used the total participation in our example. That was the strong entity. Why strong entity? Because it has the key attribute. So you can refer that lecture and that example to say that this is not a correct statement, that if someone is saying that total participation is used only with the weak entities. We can use this total participation with the strong entities also, where keys are there. Fine. Move to the next point. Something more on the weak entities. Some more discussion on the weak entities. I am showing you a separate weak entity like a insurance record. If this is a weak entity, it means it will be like this. Fine. It can have a discriminator discriminates the entities for the weak entities, basically. It is not a primary key or key, it is a partial key. It is a partial key, it is not a complete key, it is not a primary key, not a unique key, it is a partial key. This is used to discriminate the different entities for the insurance record. Like I am writing here serial number. Premium amount. Date of submission. Date of submission of premium and due date. This is the due date. This is the next date when you need to submit your next premium. This serial number can be used to discriminate different records. Serial number 1, serial number 2, serial number 3, serial number 4, like this. But this is not a key or primary key. You can see if I am written here serial number 1, premium amount 6000 rupees, date of submission is the 22nd July 15 and due date is the December 2015, 31st December, like this. This one thing, but this one is the thing, but there is no importance of this record until unless this is not related with some employee or some people. Hence, it needs a identifying entity type. In our previous example, we have taken the employee as an identifying entity type. Listen very carefully. This has no importance. If I am writing here serial number 1, premium date is something, amount is something, date is something, due date is something. Again, serial number is 2, amount is something, date of submission is something, and date of due date is something. This discriminates to each other. But still, there is no importance of any record until unless it is not associated with any other entity type or any other identifying entity type. For example, there is no importance of this record until unless it is associated with some employee. For what this record is given? Not known. No meaning of its existence until unless it is associated with some employee. Fine. Hence, we have introduced a identifying relationship. I am again writing this thing. See here. We have used total participation and here we have shown employee. Fine. What we have done? Employee has as a pen as a unique key or key. Here, serial number is a discriminator. How to represent the discriminator? With the help of dashed underlines. With the help of dashed underlines. If someone wants to say what is the primary key, till the date I have not taught you what is the primary key, but you can imagine as a key. Somebody can ask you what is the primary key of this insurance record. First thing is that no key is there for any type of insurance, any type of weak entities. But with the help of the identifying entity types, we can create a key for the given weak entity types. For example, if somebody asks what is the key attribute or primary key attribute for the given insurance record weak entity type. For this example, you can take a combination of discriminator along with the key attribute of the identifying entity type in order to give the primary key or key attribute of the weak entity type. For this example, you can write pen plus serial number is a key attribute of insurance record. So this is clear. You have to take the combination of the identifying attribute of the identifying entity type along with the discriminator in order to give the primary key or key of the weak entity type. This is very much important when you are going for the interviews or the some VIVAs. Some more notations. Hope this is clear. Fine. Some more notations. Like if this is given as this shows 1:1. This shows association. If this is given like this, this is 1:1. This is the many to many. This is many to many. Fine. We will discuss more notations in our coming lectures. This is not a complete list. We will use some more notations we have, which still we have not discussed. We will discuss in the next lecture or back today. Let us see a very basic example how to study the how to understand the given requirement and find out the database requirements and draw a ER diagram. Let us see in the example. I'm saying that a student has name, address head, street number, house number and district. Student has name, address, enrollment number, many mobile numbers, many mobile numbers. This is the important thing, many mobile numbers. Date of birth. This is a very important point because it will use the different way to notate, different way of notation. Draw an ER diagram, entity relationship diagram. ER diagram. So let us understand what is the big building block, what is the basic building block which exist independently and which is used to give the complete solution here. Let us think, take a time and think, what is this? Here, the whole decision is around the student. It means there are a lot of students, number of students we can use or we can locate with the name student that will represent the complete community of the students. Hence, this is known as entity type because this is not a single student. It represents, if you will set a standard for a single student, if I am going to set a single standard, then each and every student will have the same standard. Hence, this is known as a type. I am going to say it is a student type because I am going to set a standard for the students. Whatever the students should be set here, all the examples of this particular category or all the entities of this particular category will possess this type of, will pose this type of this all types or these properties or standards. So I am going to take here students as an entity type. Fine, this is an entity type. Now, what are the things which are associated with this entity type? What are the things which are categorizing these student types, or by what are the different features given for this student type? You can see the example here. Name should be there, address should be there, enrollment number should be there, many mobile numbers a student can have. Each student have a date of birth. Let us understand how to represent this thing. I have told you the properties or the features given for a particular type is known as the attributes. And attributes are used to represent with the help of ellipses. So let us represent. Name. If somebody says name is the combination of first name, second name, middle name and the last name, then this is the composite attribute. If somebody says that the name has first name plus middle name plus last name, then what you will do? It is simple. You have to go again like this. First name, middle name, last name. It is simple. Next, what is the address? Address is again combination of street number, house number and district. This is again a composite attribute like this. Street number, and district like this. Fine. What are the more informations or features given by a student? It must have a enrollment number. See very carefully. Enrollment number is a key attribute. By using enrollment number, we can identify the students uniquely. Hence, represent with the help of underlines like this. Fine. What more information? Many mobile numbers. A student can have more than one mobile numbers. It is possible. It is not an infeasible thing. One can have more than one mobile numbers. How to represent? This is the multi-valued attribute. Hope you have remembered these things. We have discussed in our second lecture. In second lecture, last part of the first and initial of the second lecture, where Multivalued attributes are used to represent with the help of double lined circles. And one more thing, the student must have a date of birth. This is a date of birth. I have told you, if you are going to take the date of birth, date of joining, date of retirement, like things which moves with the timing, which increase with the increase of timing, these type of values are represented with the help of derived attribute. If I have saved my age today 30, then after 10 years, we will derive if the database, if we want to fetch my date from the database, it should be 40, not it should be 30, because I have saved the age 30. This is known as derived attribute, where I am fetching the data from the some stored data, not exactly. I am putting some calculation and deriving data from some stored data. So how to represent the derived attribute? This is used to represent with the help of dotted ellipses. This is used to represent with the help of dotted ellipses, like this, like same, but dots are there. Maybe this is these are not the very are not drawing a very fine ellipses, but this is a ellipse, or other ellipse. This is double lined ellipse. This is the dotted ellipse. So this is a complete representation of this particular example. In our next lecture, we will discuss some more examples and some more presentations of the different elements which are required in the ER diagram modeling or ER modeling. Thank you for watching. Thank you.